Hello friends, Namaskar. Welcome to our Facebook page, Excel Stream. I have also created a YouTube channel, so please go and watch my videos over there as well if required. Okay, now coming back to the... So today we are going to learn about the if functions, its basics, and we'll learn about also on the comparison operators. So before coming to if function, we should learn about comparison operators in Excel. So there are six types of comparison operators present in Excel, which are equal to, okay, less than, greater than, less than equal to, greater than equal to, and this sign we will use for not equal to function. Okay, so there are six types of comparison operator which we are going to use in if function, which we can use in if functions. Okay, now coming back to in function. So what does if function do? It allows you to check a criteria and basis on the output of that criteria, logical criteria, it allows you to put your value, your desired value, formula or a function. Okay, so let's see. So let's understand it with an example. Equal to if, okay, so there are three criteria values of present over here. First is the logical test, followed by a true value, and followed by a false value. Okay, also I have defined the criteria from format over here in which you can pass your criterias. Okay, so what if you need, if you check your criteria in the terms of number format. Okay, so if, let's understand, if this value is greater than or equal to 1000, for example. So agar ye value aapki 1000 se zyada hai, so I want Excel to give me 1K and above result. Okay, if this condition is true, Excel will return this, and if the condition is false, it will give me less, it will give the value less than 1K. Okay, always remember, whenever you're passing a text argument in Excel, please surround that value with a double quotes. Okay, like we have done over here. Jab bhi aap Excel mein koi text value pass kar rahe hain, toh please remember to put a double quotes around it. Okay, see, if I put 1000 over here, it will give me 1k and above, 1200 and so on. Okay, next we'll come to criteria format of text. If you are passing a text criteria format, you should put that value in a double quotes. For example, if this cell is equal to pass, then I want Excel to return eligible. And if this value is not equal to pass, it gives me the not eligible. So what will Excel do? If this value is pass, it will give eligible, or you put any other value, it will give you a false value, okay, which is not eligible, right? The moment you put pass, it will give you not eligible. Okay, if your criteria value is in terms of percentage, also in terms of percentage, you do not need to put any double quotes around it, and you can put simply, for example, this is a, for example, we have a passing percentage of 40%. So I put a formula, main a formula lagata hun. If this value is less than 40%, okay, it will give me a fail. Okay, else it will give me a pass result. Okay, okay, the moment I put 40 and above value over here, it will give me a pass result. Okay, you can also put a decimal value, sorry, a percentage in terms of decimal as well, 0.4. so this also means 40%. Okay, 39, got it. Now how you can use a date criteria. Okay, so I will say if we'll use date value. Okay, date value, if date value of this. If this value is less than date value, we'll put 31st March. Okay, if this cell value, we put date value function over here, not date. Okay, please remember, whenever you are trying to put a criteria in a date format, you need to use the date value function. Okay, if this value is less than 31st March, we'll say eligible, or we'll say FY20, for example. Okay, else we'll put FY21 if this is for this year, FY21. Okay, it will give you FY21. Why? Because this value is greater than 31st March. The moment I enter over here 20th Feb, it will give me FY20, because this value is now less than 31st March, and it will give you a true value, which is FY20. Okay, now understand more in terms of sample. I have created some sample databases over here, okay, and put a current condition to learn more about it. Okay, so we have 6 sample databases to understand more in depth about how we can use if function. Okay, for example, these are the customer database. Over here we have a name of customers: Afzal Noor, Esthan, Rakshit Chunu, Harshish Sharma. So I have a condition over here: if the cart value, if this column value is greater than 50,000, okay, I want system to put a condition to put a discount of 15%, let's say. Okay, so how we are going to put it? Agar main chahta hoon, what I need, if the cart value, which is this column, is greater than 50,000, I want to give a customer discount of 15%. Okay, so if this value is greater than, remember, 50,000, I want 15% discount. Okay, else give 0%. It returns 0%. Why? Because this value is less than 50,000. We'll convert this into a percentage. Okay, see. Okay, and if you want the calculation, if you want to calculate the system, the value, the discounted value over here as well. So what we are going to do, we'll put 15%. You can do calculations as well in the if function into yahan pe kar lete hain, in the end, into this. Where it is, sorry, we cannot put over here. We'll do this into this cell value, else it will give me this value only. Okay, so what this function will do, kya karega ye function, if this value is greater than 50,000, what it will do, it will apply a 50% discount over here, okay, and give you the discounted value over here, else it'll put the same value. We should not use this, we'll put a discount percentage, and we'll use if this greater than 50,000, it will give you a 15% and 0% discount value. Okay, put convert into the percentage over here. Okay, now coming back to the second sample database, I want if the grade of any of the item is B, I want to give a 25% discount. Why? Because B is a lower grade value item. Okay, so sometimes you got this criteria, you can, इट इज जस्ट अ सैंपल. सो आपको कई बार ऐसा मिल सकता है कि बेसिस ऑन द ग्रेड यू योर कंपनी वॉन्ट्स टू गिव सम डिस्काउंट ऑन दैट. तो हाउ वी कैन डू इट इफ दिस वैल्यू. ओके, सिंस दिस इज अ टैक्स क्राइटेरिया वी शुड पुट डबल कोट्स. इफ दिस इज इक्वल टू बी आई वॉन्ट 20% डिस्काउंट एल्स 0% डिस्काउंट. ओके, convert this into the percentage. The moment you enter B, it will give you a 25% discount. Let's look another sample. We have a students with the name RK Marathi, Sudeep Sen, Nida Rajput and Gaurav. So if the marks is more than 40%, I want a result pass, else it will give me a fail. So how we can do that? If this value is greater than or equal to, okay, 50%, I want pass result, else I want fail result. Okay, if this value is 47, it will give you a pass, else it will give you a fail. You can check any 29%, 20%, 30%. Okay. Next sample. Okay. So this is a sample database of the pending shipments. Okay. What I want, this criteria is wrong. Okay. What I want, if the ship date is more than, I want if ship date is less than 1st July, I want system to return to check value. Okay, as I want. Okay, so since we need to check the date over here, we use date value function. If this value less than date value, right? Sorry, date value. क्या चाहते हैं? If this value is less than 1st July 2020, you can see over here 2020. Please remember to put double quotes around date as well. If this value, हम क्या चाहते हैं? अगर ये value less than 1st July है, तो system will return to check. Okay, else I want system to return. Okay, to check. Why you get result to check over here? Because yahan par aapki value is less than 1st of July. Okay, if you change this 1st Feb, you will get to check. Okay, another example. We have two more examples. So this is a dispatch register, for example, and this is the dispatch numbers dispatched on and action required. So what I want, okay, if dispatch date is blank, I want the action to be checked, else no action is required. Okay, so क्या करना है हमें इस एक्सेल के अंदर? यहाँ पर भी डेट नहीं आ रही है, हमें वहां चाहिए, हमें हम चाहते हैं कि यहाँ पर वैल्यू आ जाए टू बी चेक्ड. ओके, सो वी हैव मल्टीपल वेज ऑफ डूइंग इट. इफ दिस वैल्यू ओके इक्वल टू blank, okay, you can put double quotes to pass a blank criteria. Okay, if this is blank, so kya check, so what you want to be, sorry, it's coming in the capital, to be checked. Okay, and I want status, no action required. Why? Because we have a date over here. Okay, because we do not have any date, so this function returns to be checked. You can also check it if you want to put a blank. Agar aapko koi bhi blank value check karni hai, you can also put zero over here. Okay, if this is equal to zero, to kya aa jayega, to be checked. Okay, you can put this as well. Okay, second method, third method is you can put is blank function. Is blank. is blank, if this value is blank, so this function give you the result true or false. If this is true, it will give you to be checked, else not should required. So we have multiple ways of checking a blank value. Okay, and the last one, we can also use functions in the criteria. Okay, if you want. So in India we have a 6-digit pin code, right? And you need to check, agar aap, aur aapko check karna hai, assuming aapke paas thousands of pin code addresses hain, and you need to check ki what are those pin codes which are wrong, which have less than 6 or more than 6 characters. Okay, for example, in this case we have one value which is of less than 6 characters. Okay, so what I do, I will use a len function. Len function is used to check the length of the cell. Okay, how many characters are present in this. If this equal to, so it will return the number of characters. If this is equal to 6, if the result of this functions equal to 6, it will give correct pin code, else it will give wrong pin code. Okay, so this functions, the moment you enter correct pin code, incorrect, you put 1, it will, the moment you entered 6 digit, it will give you a correct pin code. If this is blank, it will again give you a wrong pin code. So guys, hope you like this video. If you want the sample file of this, please comment your email ID in the comment box. You can leave your email ID in the comment box. And if you have any query over this, the if functions, if you have any doubts, any question, you can leave your queries in the comment option, and I will try to get back to you it, and I will try to resolve it as soon as possible. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Have a good day. Bye.